Hey guys, this is Vesper and Kaylee again with another breakdown. This time we're doing Nash, and we're using our footage from E3 that we got, but we missed some stuff along the way, but we got what we could. So, since Kaylee pretty much played Nash for 3 days straight, Kaylee's going to be pretty much explaining most of the things here.
Okay, so going over Nash's movement, as you can see, his walk speed is slow. It's faster than Bison's, but about on par with Birdie's.
His walk speed's ass.
Yeah, both forwards and backwards. He's got a really good forward dash, though, and the back dash isn't too bad. And his jump arc is about on par with Ryu's as well. So, besides his walk speed, everything else
is like his jumping is pretty normal.
So going over his notable normals, he has quite a bit of purpose with each of his normals due to his slow walk speed and overall tool set. So starting with his stand light punch, it's actually fast on startup, and it's a target combo starter. It has good range for a light normal, and it's special cancelable on block. So a lot of times you go like, you want to end in like a stand jab into one of his specials, like Sonic Scythe or something like that.
Okay.
Moving on to his stand medium punch. It's a quite a versatile normal. Pretty decent startup. It's another target combo starter. Mediocre range. It's special cancelable. And it's mostly used as like a combo starter or even a combo filler. Then we have his stand heavy punch or hard punch. And it's pretty slow. It's got a separate animation on block, special cancelable, mostly used as a combo starter, but really crouch hard punch is better for that.
Mm-hmm.
His stand light kick, it doesn't have much range on it, but it is a combo target combo starter. Okay. It can also chain or link into itself. And it's mostly like combo starter, combo filler material. Special cancelable on block, on hit and block as
well. The animation for staying like it looks retarded.
Yeah, it's just kind of like this weird move. I don't know. It's bizarre.
Yeah.
His stand medium kick is actually a pretty decent poke. Because of how it looks, it actually moves his hurtbox to the leg that he's standing on afterwards. So you can try to use it to go over some low attacks and then tag him there. So it's a good like a footsie tool and a good poke. It's another target combo starter.
Jeez.
And it's mostly like a filler type of combo filler combo starter because of that target combo stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here. His standing hard kick, not a really good poke. Moves him forward slightly, kind of compensate for his slow walk speed. Mm-hmm. But it's a really good anti-air at farther ranges.
Okay.
So now his crouching normals. His crouch light punch is fast startup. Chains into itself into other light normals. So most of the time you kind of fish with it and then go into stand. Either his target combo or stand light punch and then special cancel afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
Crouch medium punch. The hitbox is good, but the range is kind of bad. But it's actually surprisingly really good at whiff punishing.
Okay.
So if they whiff like a low forward, like Ryu players, if they whiff low forward and you're within that range, you can actually whiff punish with that crouch medium punch and then cancel into Sonic Scythe or Sonic Boom.
Okay.
Good for combo starters, combo fillers, special cancelable, and it's actually a good anti-air at closer jump ranges. But at farther ranges, you want to use either like his stand roundhouse or crouch heavy punch.
So Nash does have anti-airs then?
He's got quite a bit of anti-airs actually.
Okay.
His crouch heavy punch or hard punch, it's amazing anti-air. This normal is actually really good in general. Like his anti-air properties is just ridiculous.
Is it his like go-to choice for an anti-air? It's basically
his go-to choice. It works at pretty much any range. It's just slightly slower startup than his crouch medium punch.
Okay.
So if you're kind of late on the response, then maybe crouch medium punch is your go-to anti-air at that closer range.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely anything like farther out, crouch heavy punch for sure.
Gotcha.
The other good thing about this is that it's probably his best combo starter for like punish combos.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Because he can link into his back medium kick afterwards, and then that gives you a two-hit confirm.
That's insane.
So it's pretty crazy. On top of that, the slowish startup on it makes it really good at throw baiting, especially after a jump in, right? You can just like delay or walk forward slightly and then go crouch heavy punch, and it's really good at throw baiting.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that it can link into his back medium kick makes it also a good frame trap tool. So you go crouch crouch, heavy punch, and then back medium kick. And there's a slight gap there for people to push buttons and stuff like that, and they get frame trapped by the back medium kick afterwards.
Okay.
So it's just a very versatile move. His crouch light kick hits low, turns into crouch light punch, basically just combo starter filler stuff. Crouch medium kick, on the other hand, is an excellent ground poke for him. It's basically his go-to footsie normal. But it's not special cancelable, and then that's kind of the biggest drawback.
Oh, okay.
It would have been actually really nice if he could special cancel into Sonic Scythe afterwards.
Yeah.
But unfortunately not, so you use it in footsies and that's about it. His crouch heavy kick or hard kick, it's just a standard sweep, good range and speed on it, just a standard footsie tool.
Mm-hmm.
Jumping normals now, his jump heavy punch. It's got good diagonal range on it, so it's mostly good for air-to-ground stuff. His jump medium kick is his cross-up in this game. Really good hitbox on it, and you can make it look ambiguous, especially when you use it in conjunction with his jump heavy kick.
Mm-hmm.
It has a good diagonal hitbox as well, probably better than his jump heavy punch. So you can really psych people out if you time your jump ins and use the jump medium kick to cross up or the jump heavy kick to not cross up.
Okay.
He also has neutral jumping normals. So his neutral jump heavy kick, it looks like kind of like a ghetto Sonic.
Yeah, he does like this backflip kind of
yeah,
thing, right?
It kind of looks like the flash kick, but not quite.
Okay.
It's good anti air-to-air thing, or even like a reactionary air-to-air.
Okay.
But the active frames is tiny on this thing, so you don't want to use this as like a neutral jump and then you try to time it late or whatever as you're going down.
All right.
The active frames are tiny, so it's not really meant for that.
All right.
But mostly it's like air-to-air as well as combo extensions with his V trigger.
All right.
So that's pretty much all of his crouching and jumping normals. Okay, going over his command normals, Nash has a ton. Probably the most in the current build of SF5.
Yeah, a million.
So starting off with his forward medium punch, this is his overhead. It's slow, doesn't have much range on it. You can target combo into it, but it's punishable on block.
Even if you use it at max range?
It's definitely negative on block at that point. But
okay.
At closer ranges, it's like free throw for them.
Okay.
Okay, moving on to his forward heavy punch. This is basically the spinning back fist that he had in the Alpha series, as well as what Guile has. Really good range on it. It's slow, kind of a good poke. The main drawback, though, is that it's really punishable on block, even at like almost max range.
Really?
Like some characters, they can just raw super and punish him for it.
Oh.
The unfortunate part is this is his crush counter.
Oh, okay, so that's why. There's a risk to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But on crush counter, it's kind of hard to combo afterwards. I think you can dash in and do a combo, but it seems kind of tight. Like you have to really be looking out for it.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you can just confirm into another back fist.
And I mean, like a forward hard kick or something.
Yeah, and then it'll knock down on hit afterwards.
Is this his only crush counter?
This is his only crush counter.
Okay.
It has an extra property. If you actually hit someone in the air, like while they're jumping at you, or during their startup of their jump, it actually knocks them down.
Oh, okay. Weird.
Okay, so now looking at his forward light kick. This is basically bazooka knee. Guile has this too. Moves him forward. Can sort of go over lows. It's definitely punishable on block. Maybe not so much at the farther ranges, but it's really awkward to use. Most people didn't really use this normal. It kind of got overshadowed by some of his other command normals here.
Yeah.
It's kind of a tick throw setup if they're sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
And it also has that same property as his forward heavy punch where it knocks the opponent down if you catch him during their jumping.
Okay.
Okay, so looking at his back medium kick command normal, it's kind of a weird command normal. He just does this knee to the gut. It's strictly combo filler as far as I know. I mean, it links right after his crouch heavy punch here, so you kind of want to use that as your go-to combo.
It's a really important combo filler,
yeah,
basically.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, now looking at his forward medium kick. This is basically soul back kick, moves him forward again. Which is kind of the general trend in all his command normals.
I'm starting to notice that.
It's a good poke. Overshadows his forward light kick command normal. Has a similar property where you can kind of go over lows with it. It's slightly negative on block from from what most Nash players were figuring out during E3. Overall, it's pretty good. It's like a way to kind of close the gap. The main difference, though, is unlike the Alpha series, you can't change the direction of it. So when you do this, you're only going forward. In the older games, you could actually go hold back and he would actually move backwards.
Right? Okay.
But you can't do that in SF5.
Okay.
All right, now his last command normal is forward heavy kick. And again, moves him forward. It's really good in the footsie game. It's just a great poke. And because of the way it looks, it's just really good in the footsie game. So you kind of use it at farther ranges and beat characters like low pokes, like reuse low forward, for example.
I've seen you land this thing a million times.
It's just
like, I've seen you use this like 3 times in a row and land a hit every single time. Like, this is really good command normal.
Yeah, it's one of his go-to command normals for sure. It's slow on startup though, so you got to be careful, but generally in the footsie game you want to use this normal.
Okay.
All right, now going over all of his target combos, he has the most amount of target combos as well.
Oh boy.
So first target combo he has is stand medium kick, heavy kick, forward medium kick. So he basically ends it in the Sobat kick.
Okay.
Combo Fiend was telling me at E3 that you kind of want to fish with this because the stand medium kick is good in footsies because it changes that hurtbox property. So if you use it to beat low pokes, you just confirm right into the target combo.
Okay.
It does knock down on hit, good corner carry, and I think if you dash right afterwards, if they quick rise, about the same speed in terms of your forward dash, like the recovery of it.
Oh, okay.
So you might be able to get a throw in or go for like a throw attempt right afterwards.
I see.
All right, his next target combo is standing medium punch, light kick, heavy punch. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Weird sequence. But yeah, basically he does his standing medium punch and then the bazooka knee and then the jumping punch.
It just took us forever to figure out how to do this too.
Yeah, it took us 2 days to figure it out. Nobody else on the ground floor could figure out what this target combo was.
But yeah, because it goes backwards from medium punch to light kick.
Yeah, and the whole sequence is just really awkward in general. Like like I said, after the bazooka knee, that jump punch he does looks like his jumping heavy punch. So the whole thing looks kind of wonky.
Was it worth figuring out? Is there
It's so-so. It's not that great.
Yeah.
It does knockdown on hit. It has some kind of interesting things post-knockdown.
Mm-hmm.
Not in terms of setups, but maybe like a throw setup or something like that.
This is good corner carry too.
Yeah, it has good corner carry.
Okay.
Okay, so his next target combo is stand light kick, medium kick. It's basically just a good, nice light hit confirm.
Mm-hmm.
You can't special cancel it though, so
weird.
The reason for that, I think, is because you can actually link into his other target combo, which is stand light punch medium punch.
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of want to, the range on this is not that good. You kind of want to do this point blank or after a cross up or something like that.
Okay.
But it's just a really good like hit confirm after jump ins or something like that. You can also link into it off of like crouch light kick, crouch jab, something like that.
Okay,
his next target combo is stand light punch medium punch. As I mentioned previously, you can link into this from his stand light kick medium kick target combo, and you saw this a lot during E3 in various other footage.
Everyone
who's
playing Nash right now is doing this kind of combo, the light kick medium kick light punch medium punch.
It's just a super easy confirm, but I think as it progresses, most people are going to shift to that crouch heavy punch back medium kick.
Okay.
Link. But yeah, this is just like the really easy combo, day one combo.
But you have to be really close when you do it.
Yeah, the biggest problem is that medium punch doesn't have much range. So if you're not close to them, it has a tendency to whiff a lot. So it was mostly good if you were at point blank or after his cross up medium kick. But if you did like a regular jump in, like jump heavy kick, and then you tried it, a lot of the times your medium punch would whiff.
So you can't do like light kick, medium kick, and then light punch, medium punch into Sonic Boom, for example. Or sorry, since you're not in range, you can't do light kick, medium kick, and then light punch, Sonic Boom. And you can't do that.
You could. You probably could.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of the problem is people want to confirm into the target combo, right?
Yeah.
This is just like muscle memory, and so they don't really fully understand the range, and mm-hmm. so it just catches them off guard on whiff. But yeah, I think if you understand that it's gonna whiff, you could probably just link into the light punch and then cancel into Sonic Scythe.
So it's basically light kick, medium kick, slight pause, light punch, medium punch.
Yeah.
Okay.
So easy, very easy combo. The link timing isn't that bad.
Okay.
Okay, his last target combo is crouch medium punch, forward medium punch. So this is the target combo into his overhead.
Oh.
Just a quick way to get some damage, trick people.
Yeah.
And just try to open up in other ways. It's also a good way to set up like a tick throw setup after the overhead.
Too bad it doesn't hit low though with the crouching medium punch.
Yeah.
Because then it'd be kind of like Guile.
Guile, yeah.
Yeah.
But that'd be too good, I think.
Oh boy.
Okay, so he also has an air throw. It seemed like it was pretty fast on startup. And it's actually one of his anti-air options. So if you see them jump and you're close to them, you can respond with just straight up air throw. But yeah, he has a lot of different anti-air options. That's just another one of them. All right, now moving on to his special moves. The first one being Sonic Boom. Everyone's familiar with this one. But the main difference is it's no longer a charge move. It's now done by doing core circle forward and punch. And this was throwing off a lot of people at E3.
Yeah, there's a lot of people just, you know, naturally doing the charge, not checking the new move list and that. And it took them a while to realize that it actually is just a normal core circle forward punch now.
So yeah, as a result of that, though, the properties of the Sonic Boom is drastically different than the charge version of it.
Okay.
So the strength of the button you use increases the startup, but decreases speed and recovery. So the light punch version is good for like block strings or if you're doing it at close range. The medium punch version is mostly good for combos, mid-range zoning. But the heavy punch version is great only at farther distances because it has the most startup on it, but the least amount of recovery. And it travels slower too. So you can...
What? Really?
Yeah, it travels the slowest among them. So you can actually like follow it right afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
So just kind of opposite of what
Guile
does.
Yeah, it's kind of backwards. Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, you do this at far range, you throw a heavy Sonic Boom, and then you can like dash into it, and then like in front or behind, stuff like that, and just use it as a shield.
Okay.
The EX version, by default, he just throws one projectile or one Sonic Boom. But if you push punch again, he throws another Sonic Boom.
It's kind of like his old school super in Alpha.
Yeah, so you kind of want to gauge when to use that second Sonic Boom. If you're zoning, you can actually watch what the opponent does. If they jump, then you don't throw the second Sonic Boom.
So you got some time to delay just a little bit, yeah. Or just throw it one after the other.
Exactly. Good in block strings, good in, can be used as a combo ender, though I wouldn't really want to use it as a combo ender.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on to his next special move, Moonsault Slash. And it was kind of deceiving because of the way it looks. It's basically like a Don's Jaguar kick.
Okay.
But you don't need to do it in the air. It's only done by going core circle forward kick.
So you can't do this in the air?
You can't do this in the air.
Okay.
The strength that you use increases the distance that he travels. It sort of tracks, but the tracking is kind of wonky on it.
Okay.
The light kick version travels the least amount of distance, but it's plus on block. So most of the time you want to do like a quick block string into this and you want to really like apply pressure on them because they can't push buttons, you're plus, so you can go like crouch jab afterwards and kind of repeat it. A lot of the time you saw people go like the jab medium punch target combo into this, jab medium punch target combo.
Oh, just like close the distance.
Yeah, and they start looping it.
It's kind of like a knee press or something like that.
Yeah, but it's slow on startup so they can hit you out of the air of it, but like you use it occasionally to kind of throw them off and really apply pressure and chip damage and stuff like that.
Okay.
The medium kick version, it seemed like it was negative on block. Like I got stuffed if I tried pushing buttons afterwards and I don't know if I was just mistiming my follow-up button.
Okay.
But it seemed like it was negative on block. It travels a little bit further and kind of used to go over projectiles. Same with the heavy kick version. Heavy kick version travels the most distance of the regular versions and kind of used to go over fireballs, and it also seemed like it was plus on block, just slightly.
Okay.
You can't combo off of these, even on counter hit. It just didn't seem like it was possible from all the testing that we were doing. The EX version, though, does two hits, but oh my god, this move is terrible.
This move is ass.
It's like the worst special move in the game.
I mean, it's one of the first moves you were trying to like make work when you were playing, and it just... I don't know, the tracking is just weird. It doesn't track properly.
Like, it travels full screen, pretty much, or almost full screen.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, the hitbox on the first one, because what he does like, one one set of like flip kicks, and then he does like the next set of flip kicks.
Mm-hmm.
But that first set, the hitbox isn't that good, so sometimes it whiffs, or he goes right over the opponent, and then it whiffs, and you're just stuck there. It's like whiffing an ultra.
Yeah, it's like Nash doesn't give a shit where you are after he decided to like jump at you. It's like wherever he was left is where Nash is going to start kicking. And if the opponent's moved at any point afterwards, after you employ that attack, he's just like suspended in air and just begging to get punished.
It's terrible. So I think you would use this in like heavy anticipation of a fireball or on stun, because after it hits, if you manage to get it to hit.
Yeah, you deserve a huge reward.
You can combo off of it. So I think at best you can go crouch, medium punch, and then do some crazy like V-trigger combo afterwards.
Okay.
But yeah, you ain't landing this at all.
Yeah, they should make this move instant kill, and that would balance it out.
Pretty much. If you manage to land it, you should get rewarded.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, moving on to his next special, we have Sonic Scythe. This is done by going quarter circle back and kicks. The light kick version hits the legs, medium kick version hits the chest, and then the heavy kick version is like that genocide cutter type move, right? They all do one hit except for the heavy kick version, which does like 2-3 hits. I can't remember off the top of my head here. They all cause a knockdown, but they're all unsafe on block. Even the light kick version.
Oh,
If you do this at like close range, they can like combo punish you.
Oh, okay.
But like a medium kick kind of punish, like a light punish, unless they have super or something. Mm-hmm. But yeah, these are strictly combo enders. You can sort of use the light kick version as a poke, but you got to do it at like max range, otherwise you risk getting punished. The heavy kick version, it looks like it would be a good anti-air, but it's not.
It's just too slow.
It's just, yeah, it is a little too slow. If you do it in anticipation, you can sort of get it to work as an anti-air, but there are much better options, more reliable options to anti-air.
And just to clarify, guys, Nash doesn't have a flash kick in this game.
Yeah, he's got no invincible reversal. Even the EX version of Sonic Scythe, it looks like it would be invincible, and like his go-to reversal, it's not. Has no invincibility whatsoever. You can use it as an anti-air, but again, you have to be a little bit quicker in response to it.
Is this your only like reversal option?
It's kind of like, if you had a reversal option, this would be it.
Okay.
But it's not reliable, because it's faster on startup. Mm. So like most people, if they try to pressure, they might get clipped by the first hit, and then the rest captures, right? But as a get-off-me move, it's like not that good.
So the EX version of the Sonic Scythe is basically used as a combo finisher, damage combo finisher.
Definitely combo finisher.
Okay.
Does 3 hits, if I remember right.
It juggles pretty proper, like pretty well, though. Like I've seen from the V-trigger combos, like it does hit all the time.
Yeah, it's pretty damaging too, especially as the combo ender.
Okay.
So his last special move is Tragedy Assault, and unfortunately, we completely flubbed up and did not record any footage of it. And
that was Kelly's fault, not my fault.
What do you mean my fault?
It's not my fault, man. It's your camcorder.
So yeah, we completely forgot about Tragedy Assault.
What's the input for it?
It is Dragon Punch motions.
Oh boy.
And punch.
Okay.
So basically, it's a Dragon Punch.
Okay.
It doesn't act like a Dragon Punch, though.
No.
It's not a command grab as it looks. It's just a command hit, and then he goes into that full animation.
Kind of like a Ibuki's neck breaker.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's an interesting special, because the strength of it determines the distance and the startup time. So as you increase the strength, it takes longer to start up, but he travels farther.
Okay.
It's mostly a combo ender. And the interesting aspect of it is that it drains the opponent's meter on hit.
Weird. Did anyone notice that?
Some people caught it from the pre-E3 videos that were coming out.
Interesting.
The heavy punch version, though, is an overhead.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Why only the heavy punch version?
I have no idea. It's super slow, though.
Oh, okay.
That's the thing. So you're kind of putting together Nash's strategy, and you kind of... There's a lot to absorb with Nash, but if you put together all his tool sets, yeah, you kind of need to use this once in a while to really throw them off guard, because it's like the last thing they kind of expect.
Okay.
They all knock down on hit, and they're all just like basically combo ender material.
Can you V-cancel all of all the strikes?
I don't know about the normal version, but I know you can off of the EX version.
And okay.
The EX version is actually even more interesting. It is faster on startup than the heavy punch version, but on top of draining the opponent's meter, it actually regens health.
Weird. Weird. So it drains their health, basically.
Yeah.
And their meter. Okay. Yeah.
You gain health back, but you don't gain their meter.
Okay.
You only drain their meter, but you don't gain that
meter
you drain.
Okay. Is it still an overhand?
No, it's not, unfortunately.
That's so weird, man.
Yeah, only the heavy punch version.
Okay.
You can V-trigger cancel off of the EX version. I'm just not sure about the regular one.
Yeah, so. Yeah, you definitely have more than enough time. We've seen that in the trailer, too,
yeah.
Didn't we?
Yeah. And I'm just not sure, like, the best combo. Like, there's a trailer that's out there. Not a trailer, but a video out there where there's a sick combo afterwards, but we couldn't get it to work in E3. I had, like, two or three other, like, L.I. Joe and Nerd Josh and LPN, like, trying to do this combo, too. And we couldn't get it to work.
The Nash Army.
We couldn't get it to work. So, I think I have a theory on it, but, yeah, I'll do that during the beta. Moving on to his V skill. This is kind of a surprising V skill.
Yeah.
He kind of extends his arm out, and then he, like, kind of retracts it afterwards. It has, like, this little glowing property to it. If it collides with a fireball, he just nullifies the fireball. The timing on this is kind of interesting because you think you would kind of like time it as a parry, but you don't. It's kind of slowish on startup, but the active frames are huge. So you basically throw it out early and let the active frames take care of the fireball for you.
Okay.
So I got screwed up a lot of times, especially against Valle. I try to time it as his fireball comes out.
Like a parry.
Yeah, and okay. I would get hit. But if I actually threw this out earlier, it would have taken care of it for me.
Okay.
It can't nullify EX or multi-hitting projectiles.
Okay.
So he just gets stuffed altogether. Like, if you try to do this against reused Dengen fireballs, like when they're charged, he can't. He can't even nullify one hit.
Oh, okay.
So he just gets hit by anything multi-hitting.
All right.
It actually has a hitbox on it, too. So you can use it as a poke. And surprisingly, it's one of his best pokes in the game.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Like, it's kind of fast on startup, even though I said it was like kind of slow against fireballs.
Mm-hmm.
As a poke, it's good. Like, it's kind of fast for you. And the hitbox is just amazing on it. Like, and because the active frames are so good, like, I've seen it anti-air. I've seen it, like, stuff so many other attacks. Like, this is a surprisingly really good poke. And this is important because he needs that V-gauge for his V-trigger.
Mm-hmm.
And he builds one-third of V-gauge stock in both scenarios, so against projectiles and as a poke. So definitely abuse his V skill in the neutral game.
That's crazy. Like, when you look at it, it looks really plain compared to everybody else's V skills, but the fact that you can't attack with it, and the fact that he gains V gauge from just using it as a poke in general, besides, you know, just nullifying projectiles, that's pretty damn good, man.
Yeah, it's definitely important.
I like it.
He can't special cancel out of it, and as far as
that'd
I can
be
tell,
insane.
Yeah,
that'd be insane.
And he can't really combo into it. Maybe off of like
a jumping heavy.
Jumping heavy, but like maybe not off, definitely not off of his grounded normals, unless you manage to land like a sick counter hit or whatever like
yeah.
that. But pretty big sacrifice on damage if you want to combo into
yeah,
it.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, now we move on to the most interesting aspect of Nash, which is his V trigger. It's probably the most unique out of all the characters.
It's different from everyone else, for sure.
So how it works is that it's a single use, and it's not an install-based V-trigger like the other characters.
There's no timer whatsoever.
So once you use it, it drains the entire V-gauge. And so how it works is it's a teleport, and based on the direction that you hold, when you do the V-trigger, he teleports to different areas in relation to the opponent.
Okay.
So all the teleports track the opponent, but if you go forward in V-trigger, he teleports behind the opponent, but he stays grounded. So this is kind of mostly used to punish fireballs or set up mix-ups with his sonic boom. Most people got hit by it on day one, but as people got used to it, that sonic boom forward V-trigger was easily blocked stuff.
The teleport is still fast,
it's
man.
Really fast. Really
I got
fast.
Hit by it by a bunch of times, even though I knew it was coming. Like, it's weird. It's faster than you think.
But most people got used to it as E3 went on.
Okay.
The down V trigger teleports above and in front of the opponent. It's not really good for mix-ups, but good for combo extensions.
Okay.
The back V trigger teleports above and behind the opponent. So you can sort of use it for mix-ups, but again, mostly used for combo extensions. And there's some really crazy combo extensions you can do with his V trigger.
All right.
So the interesting part of it is that you can V-trigger cancel the majority of his specials and normals on any point, like whiff, block, whatever.
Yeah, that's really unique so far. Like, with all the characters we've seen so far, there's no one that can V-cancel off to whiffed normals and specials. It's only Nash so far that we've seen.
Yeah, so like his sonic boom, you can throw it out on whiff, like as a mix-up, and you just throw it out and then you V-trigger cancel it right away. Or even like midway through and you just V-trigger cancel, and then yeah, he can do that.
Mm-hmm.
Moon's Sonic Scythe, sorry, the Roundhouse Sonic Scythe, or even the EX version, you can V-trigger cancel at any point. Like, I've seen people V-trigger cancel the EX version of Sonic Scythe on like the second or third hit of it.
So just before he leaves the ground, basically?
No, well, he's already in the air at that point.
Oh, weird.
Yeah. So you can do it like pretty much at any point during EX Sonic Scythe, and they do it like they throw it out as a reversal, and the opponent blocks it or it whiffs, and then to keep themselves safe, they V trigger cancel right away.
That's pretty deep. That's pretty deep.
Yeah, that's really versatile for him.
Okay.
It's also a pretty good reversal tool to escape pressure, but it's like really pricey to do.
It is. It definitely is.
But like if you're in the corner and they've got like pressure, you can just throw it out there and just get out.
They have to respect it still.
Yeah.
So what happens if you press your V trigger, just like hard punch and heavy kick at the same time without any direction? What happens?
Nothing happens.
Really?
Yeah, you have to hold a direction.
Okay.
So moving on to his V reversal, it's probably the most interesting.
Yeah, it's the only interesting V reversal in the game so far.
So unlike the others, it's not really like an alpha counter where they strike back.
Mm-hmm.
What happens is Nash teleports behind the opponent and it tracks the opponent. So no matter where they are, he will always teleport behind the opponent. So if you block a fireball, like say they throw a fireball from full screen and they stay in that position, you block that fireball and then you V reversal, you will always teleport behind them.
Yeah, you can like close the distance. That's kind of like using half your bar than the entire bar basically if you use your V trigger.
Exactly.
Right?
But the only difference is that this one has more recovery on it.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
So you have to be careful with its use. So now his critical art. This is a one-hit critical art, and then it captures and goes into that full animation that people have seen. It's really fast on startup, like surprisingly fast.
Okay.
It's not strike invincible.
So you can just hit him out of it, basically.
Yeah, so I've seen it where like someone threw out a sweep, and then he activated his critical art, and then he got swept right after.
Okay.
So it's definitely not strike invincible, but it might be projectile invincible because it can be used to punch fireballs.
Makes sense.
It can also be used as an anti-air during the peak of their jump, though. So if they're already descending, it might be too late to catch them. But if you can kind of catch them or activate the critical art just as they're reaching the peak of their jump, you'll catch them for sure.
Okay.
And you can actually combo into this from like a stray Sonic Boom hitting. So you throw out a Sonic Boom, you're buffering the super, Sonic Boom hits, and then if you activate the super at that point, it will combo.
Oh, okay. But so, Sonic Scythe is like the most reliable way to combo into it.
Yeah, right? Yeah. You always want to just go Sonic Scythe and then cancel into the super.
The
yeah.
Light Kick and the Medium Punch? Or
Light
medium
Kick
or?
And Medium Kick. If you do Heavy Kick, Sonic Scythe, and then you cancel the super whiffs.
Okay. And then he does his fatality on them, basically.
Yeah, just expecting them to split in two. Right
yeah,
afterwards.
Seriously.
So in this section of the video, we're just going to list a bunch of combos that you can do with Nash. There's a ton you can do, so have fun with the V-trigger combos.
Hopefully won't write too much, but yeah.
Yeah, so thanks for watching, guys. And follow the channel to see other character breakdowns.
Okay, take it easy, guys.